This week, the Sacramento County District Attorney's Office announced the results of Operation Cross Country. Through the nationwide enforcement campaign, which was held in July, hundreds of sex trafficking victims were rescued and their captors were arrested. In Sacramento County specifically, there were four operations. Two juveniles were found. At least 12 potential adult human trafficking victims were offered services. There were five traffickers arrested. And this morning, we welcome human trafficking prosecutor, Deputy District Attorney Courtney Martin. Courtney, good morning, and thanks for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me this morning.
Talk about how big of a problem trafficking is in our area.
Yeah, so for a long time, we actually didn't really have an answer to that. Mm-hmm. And then there was a study that was done between 2015 and 2020 that was conducted by one of our community partners that we work with. It's called Community Against Sexual Harm, mm-hmm. CASH. And it was actually one of just 12 studies that have been done nationwide on the prevalence of human trafficking. And what they estimated is that in those 5 years, approximately 13,079 people were trafficked in Sacramento. Wow. So it's a tremendous problem.
Yeah. Okay, so let's jump in. These numbers that we saw, mm-hmm. specific to this area, they may seem small to some people, but how does it impact the network? Obviously, there is a network for this to happen.
Right. Well, you know, one of the things that was really helpful about the CASH study is that not only did they give us some quantitative data, but they also gave us qualitative data. They did 159 interviews with victims and survivors of human trafficking. And what they asked, you know, how does, for example, the arrest of the trafficker impact the person's ability, sure. to get out of this, you know, this world? And one of the trends that they saw through those interviews was that the arrest of the trafficker, even if it doesn't result in a long incarceration, did facilitate the exit from trafficking, mm-hmm. and from, honestly, this lifestyle that involves, you know, repeated commercial sexual exploitation. Yeah.
How do you believe that some of these victims, especially the juveniles, the children, mm-hmm. how do you believe that they're getting involved in this world? And ultimately, how can parents and families make sure their children don't become victims?
Well, the answer to that primarily is social media.
Oh, wow.
Okay. So there's a huge amount of recruitment that happens on social media, where traffickers reach out to young people, and a lot of these young people have vulnerabilities, mm-hmm. in their life, and so traffickers are manipulative. They understand that, and they seek to exploit those weaknesses. And so they find out about maybe a history of neglect or abuse in the home.
And that's from social media.
Right.
Wow.
Exactly. So these kids post things that sort of expose their vulnerabilities, mm-hmm. and traffickers zero in on that and start conversations with them. They may portray themselves as someone younger. They may misportray themselves, or they may be upfront about who they are, in terms of, you know, their age and things like that. They'll often portray themselves as a potential love interest, as a potential boyfriend, and that's how they suck, you know, particularly these young girls into, mm-hmm. this.
Wow, that is incredibly interesting. I appreciate you being here this morning. Such an important topic for all of our viewers. We do want to mention, if you or someone you know is a victim of trafficking and you need help, call the National Human Trafficking Hotline. You can call that number 24 hours, 7 days a week. The number there on your screen, 1-888-373-7888. You can speak to someone in both English and Spanish. Again, Courtney, thanks so much for being with us this
morning.
Thanks
for having me.